Good morning to all of you, and I'm back at it. Time to get to work. See how far we can get today.
Todd's studio is up here on this hillside. He's at the base of the what we call the Gravelies. That's the hills on this the western side of the Madison Valley. That's the painting I traded for. I love it. I think he does a great job. His sketches are just, nobody can touch them. What I'm doing is I'm not worrying about every detail of muscle and tendon, because this is all going to be covered with a legging, a leather legging. The only other thing I'm going to do is make sure I got the shape right, because the legging still has to fit on the leg and it has to look like a leg. I'm not worried about the inside of the leg, because this is all going to be covered with a loincloth that has to be filled, backfilled. Loincloth here. And so I'm not worried about the little holes here, because all that's going to be filled in anyway. You just don't want to waste your time on a lot of useless work. I'm just double checking from the hip down to the knee. Just make sure that these two links are the exact same. And they are. Okay. One reason why this looks longer is because this hip is dropped down, because no weight on this leg, but the weight is on this leg. That's why the femur protrudes here. And so you just have to understand a little bit about that. What I did it earlier too is I sketched in the basic of the shape of the hip, and then I just fill in the clay for the muscles. All right, let's get back to it. Okay, what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a break now. I've had several people come in to visit, and I've gone up and this is a good thing of my own, and so this day is pretty well shot. I got the legging started. And the reason I've got this flap here is because that's what would happen. They would have it sewn up to about right there, and the rest would be just two ends, and then they just tie them together around the belt. And that's what held them onto the belt. I'll continue this tomorrow.